Hello, my loves. It's Liz Ann here from High Vibes Life, helping you make the rest of your life the best of your life. And if you haven't already, please subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. So today I am going to give you 5 things that you can do right now to make your life feel more magical. So we are no longer in the dark ages. We have knowledge and understanding of things today that couldn't even be brought into the imagination probably 150 years ago. And one of the things that we do understand today is that we are magical beings. We are creating our reality. We create our reality by what we think, what we say, and by what we do. So life is very magical. And the day of not understanding what magic is gone. What it is the energetic manipulation of the vibrations that you are emitting from your auric field. So children are natural magical beings. And often we find ourselves looking at children and saying to ourselves, I wish I could have some of their energy. I wish I could get back some of that excitement for life and living. Well, we can. And how we do that is by doing what they're doing. And that is going after what you really want and love. That's what children do. They get up and they are all about, what do I want to do next? What do I want to explore next? What do I want to experience next? So I want to share with you 5 ways to bring back this magical feeling for life. And the first way is you need to conjure the feeling. In order to conjure the feeling, you need to know for yourself what a magical feeling is. And so the best thing to do is to try to remember back at any moment during the day or during your lifetime when you felt extremely just high and magical. Like life just felt like it was pure bliss. Think back on an occasion or notice it when you're going about your day and you may have a little moment where life just for that moment, it might just be a few seconds, but for a moment you catch a glimpse of just pure bliss and you're not even sure why, you just know it feels like bliss at this moment. It might be the way the light's coming in through the window or a song that you hear on the radio. And then when you feel this bliss and this magic, take a second to really feel it and to ask yourself, why is this so blissful to me? What makes this feel so blissful? Is it the light? Is it the music? What are the combinations around me of sight, sound, smell, atmosphere, people? What are the combinations around me right now that are bringing and conjuring up this feeling of magical bliss? Another thing you can do is you can remember times when you felt that magical bliss and then really put yourself into that memory and conjure that feeling. Once you've gotten a taste of what that feeling is, now you can, on a regular basis, as many times as a day as you think about it, re-conjure up that feeling by remembering the incident in which you felt it and allow yourself to feel it again as you bring it into your memory as much as possible. Just milk it, milk it, milk it. Number 2, when you are out and about and you experience something that feels magical, like say you go out to lunch and it just, the atmosphere and the food and the decor and everything just feels blissful, relaxing, and magical to you. Take a moment to really take note of that and ask yourself, what is it about this particular place and time that feels so blissful and magical? Is it the people I'm with? Is it the plant on the table, the light in the room, the music, the atmosphere? Just really take note of that. And then try to replicate that in your home as much as possible. So ask yourself, how much of this could I recreate in my living space? For instance, One time I was at a place where I just felt really light and free and blissful, and I noticed that every table had a little aloe vera plant, and I was really drawn to that. I just thought that added to the atmosphere, that added something special. And so I set about to get myself a little aloe vera plant and put it on my table in my home and to clear the table. The other thing I noticed is that everything seems so clear and clean and bright. And so I cleared the table, put the aloe vera plant in it, and let the light in, and it recreated this magical feeling that I felt at that place. So when you're at places that you feel that magic, ask yourself, what is it about it that you absolutely love and feels magical about it? And then try to replicate that in your own living space. The third thing is similar to number two, but it's particularly finding a space to clear the clutter out and to make it magical. So for me, sometimes it's my kitchen table and sometimes it's the living room coffee table. Those are the two main spaces. Once in a while I do the top of my dresser. Sometimes I'll do all three, but I usually try to focus on one so I don't feel overwhelmed because we're living busy lives. But perhaps you just want to bring in that feeling of magic and you feel kind of blah, blah, you know, and how do I do this? Well, the best way to do it at that point is just to clear a space to create magic in it. Say, ask yourself, how can I bring some magic into here? So if the coffee table is all cluttered with books and, you know, cups and different things, just one at a time, saying, what do I need to take away from this first that doesn't add to the magic of it? And just one at a time, remove it and put it back where it goes. Just make it a small space and one simple step at a time. So get it cleared off little step by step, and then clean it, wipe it down, and then start adding to that space little magical relics, like perhaps a candle or an incense or crystal that makes you feel really magical. I have oracle cards, and sometimes I'll add a card that I picked out for the day. You can add a plant or a flower or a little figurine that you love that feels magical to you. Dragon, fairy, it might be angel, whatever feels magical to you, and just add it to that space. You can see yourself actually creating an atmosphere of magic in just this little space, just starting small. And when you start small, that little small growth is like a little seed. It'll start to grow and sprout. Number four, use YouTube and search out magical ambience, and then pick ones that feel particularly magical to you when you have them on in the room, and fill your room up with the music or the picture or the sights and the sounds. There's so many beautiful ones out there. There's fairy ones. I love the Harry Potter ambience, the common rooms and the rainy nights, and sometimes the fairy enchantment ambience is particularly beautiful. Or sometimes I'll just do Reiki energy clearing music. But bring an ambience in through YouTube. You can get both the visual and the sounds, and it just adds such a beautiful ambience and atmosphere to create that magical feeling within your living space. And number five is to create a spell. Now you might be saying, what? I don't do spells. But hear me out. Spell is part of the word spelling. Writing is powerful. So when you actually write down something, you are actually manifesting something into physical already by putting it down in a physical journal and spelling it out. So take some time to write in a journal or write on a piece of paper, particularly a piece of paper, something that you can have access to all the time, easily access to, and write out what that magical feeling is to you. Bring to mind step one of conjuring the feeling of feeling magical, and then just begin to write. It might help to write what a magical day would start like and be like throughout the day, what it would feel like, what would you do, what would you say, what would your surroundings look like, how would your home feel, how would work feel, how would it feel driving or going, getting tune from work or tune from running your errands, how would they all feel? Just write it out as clear as possible. And then read this often. Read it often, especially first thing in the morning, so that you can carry it throughout the day. And then in the evening is another good time to read it. But first thing in the morning, read it to yourself, and then rewrite it 1 to 2 times a month as you are working on bringing these magical feelings into your life. They're going to evolve. You're going to find more things that feel magical. And so reread it, rewrite it, and keep working on this continuously throughout your life. And as you do this, you are going to have more and more experiences of feeling completely blissful and magical. And it's really quite addictive when you start doing it. You notice more and more when you're pulled away from that feeling of magic, which is the feeling of being alive, the feeling of really experiencing the bliss of this dimension that we live in right now. So I hope this has been helpful to you. If it has, please give it a thumbs up. Please share with anybody that you think might enjoy this video. And please leave down in the comments ways that you conjure up magical feelings in your life. Have a good day.